Hi all, welcome to TechFest Java. In this tutorial we are basically discussing about one of the important questions which is being asked in interviews about that is immutable classes. So firstly we will know that what is immutable classes, and then we will discuss that any of the custom class, how can we make a immutable class or immutable object. So first we discuss what is immutable classes or immutable objects. Immutable objects are those which cannot be changed once it is being created and initialized. That means once any of the class object is being created and their values, instance variable values being initialized, then after it won't be changed. So that type of class objects which are called immutable class objects. In Java, basically all the wrapper classes like boolean, integer, or double, float, all these wrapper classes are immutable classes. Apart from that, string is also an immutable class. So second thing is that what is the importance of this immutable classes? So basically immutable classes are concept which is being come because in real time applications there are many bean objects which having important data and which is being traveled to the network, and those fields which somehow being not manipulated, for that reason they've created a immutable classes or immutable objects. In Java, how can we define or how can we create a immutable classes or a simple class, how can we make that immutable class? So for that I have taken one example called a class user, and I have created one Java project where I have defined one main class, that is immutable object main class, and I have defined one model class that is called user. And in this class I have created three fields. One is a name which is of string type, one is the age which is of integer type, and one is of roles which is of map type. So how can we make this particular class objects as immutable? So I am just writing it down one by one of the conditions by which we can make an object or class as immutable. So the first thing is that first thing comes into my mind that how can we take these values and change it values by using an inheritance. When some other class inherit that particular class, then they have their variable success, right? So firstly we need to restrict that. How can we restrict to make it inherit a particular class? So we can just mark it as final. If we make that class mark as final, then no other class can inherit the that particular class. For example, I'll show you. If I write it, suppose we have created one class A, and now I am trying to extend that particular class user, then it is giving error like type A cannot be subclass the final class user. So by marking that particular class as final, we are able to restrict to make it inherit. Now the second thing is that we have to make all the mutable fields as final. So here string is immutable, integer is immutable, but integer wrapper is mutable. So what we will do, we can mark all the fields as final. And here what we can do, we can take this initialized with this with a constructor. So we can create a constructor, and here we can do the initialization. And we will pass that map type of defined roles. Now in this constructor, basically there is a one condition, all the immutable fields, whichever we defined as the immutable fields, we can directly initialize with the constructor argument passed parameters. But whatever the fields which are mutable, we have to make a deep cloning of those fields. So like here, name is defined as a string type and a string is a immutable field, so we can define this with the same value. Age is an integer type and integer of wrapper is also a immutable field, so we can define the same way. But map roles is defined as map type and map is mutable, it can be changeable. So what we will do, we will create here one map and do the deep cloning for it. So we will create a temp map equal to new mesh map. And here we will define map dot entry string, and value of type is also a string. We will take it as entry set, and here we can take this dot key set. And that way, what we can do, we can just put the values get key and sorry, this we have entry dot get value. So in that way we can populate the value in this map. Let me just and after this what we can do, we can define as this dot roles. So this need to be this, and we can make it as temp this, and the second condition is happened. So the first condition was make the class as final. This was the first condition. Second condition, make all, say define all the fields as final. Third condition, initialize all fields using constructor. And the fourth condition come here. Make deep cloning of all mutable fields. So here map is a mutable field, so we have created a deep cloning of that, and then after we have been initialized. Now the fifth condition for making any class as immutable is only provide getters of fields. So here what we will do, we will create only the getters for that. So we have been created getters only. Now the sixth condition, and which is basically the last condition, make deep cloning in getters of mutable fields and return cloned field reference. So here we are directly returning the roles which is being defined in this class. So still we can make it the changes for this class. So how we can do the deep cloning for that? The same thing which we did it in constructor, we have to do it in here. In place of this roles, we just define over here, and here we need to return this temp map, not the actual role class. This actual role map we don't need to return from here. We have to create the deep cloning of this, and that deep cloned object we need to be written. So as well, we can say that these are the steps for making any of the custom class as immutable. So this is basically the mostly asked interview question, interviewer create one class and define some immutable and mutable fields, and then they ask that how can you make this class as immutable, so can you write it down a code for it. So these kind of questions can be handled by these six steps. We can make it these six step class and do the things for making it a class as immutable. Okay, so now we have been created this class as immutable. Now we can just test it out by calling or creating an object from main class. Okay, so what do we do? We just create one map of role type. And in that map, what we will do, we will put some values like first row admin, we will define this second role, we DBA. We'll define the third role. Programmer. And now we are going to create an object of user class. So here we will pass the name as TechFest Java. We will define the age as 25. And in roles, we will pass this map. Now, we have been get that object user. Now, if this user is an immutable object, then obviously we cannot change these values of an object. So what we will do, let's just print out. And then after we will try to change their values. One more thing we can just define here. We will define this toString method so that it will print and we can better understand the program. So okay. Now, what we will do, we just get the map defined roles from this user.getRoles. And now what we will do, we just try to add some values in it. And we put fourth role. Fourth role, and that role will be manager. And then after, what we will do, we will just print out this user object again and check that is it being initialized or not. See, as you can see, in both the cases, before adding this role and after adding this role and before adding this role map giving the same result. So before creation of this object, we have whatever the being we have been initialized at the time of creation, it's still there. The object is not being changed, object values is not being changed. Now to show that it is a mutable behavior or not, what we will do from here, I'm just commenting out this part. and return directly the roles, which is basically the, this is the property. And here also I'm not making a deep cloning. What we will do, we just define this dot roles equal to this, and now run this same code again and check that what will happen. See, after adding this role, now it is showing into a user object. That means we can change it. So that's why this fourth step and this sixth step is important, to make all the mutable fields clone, deep clone. I hope you got my point in this, because there is a lot of confusion between this deep cloning. So most of them are asking why deep cloning is required. So that is the reason deep cloning is required, because if you are not making a deep cloning of the mutable objects, mutable fields, then we can easily do the modification and it will break the immutability concept. So we can now change our original code. So that's it in this video. This is basically an immutable object creation. Thank you for watching this video.